You need the decision maker. You need the decision maker.
I don't talk to 10 people. What I need is a decision maker.
That's right, yeah.
Did you stand up? Here goes. Someone's gonna get hurt. Get out of the way.
So anyways, my search, I've finally found one of these. I got this one, and it's pretty rough. This one came right from Ontario, but my plan is to put this on the, mount it right on the outside of the building. So anyways, they've already, they've cut the front off of it, the windshield there, and the top of it, but I'm kind of contemplating whether to put it back on, or not put it back on, but weld something up there, and I don't know, it won't look right though, that's the thing. And I got this bumper, man, is it ever rough. But I think what I'm gonna do is, this is gonna be painful cutting up something that's old and vintage, but that's what's gotta be done. I'm gonna cut this bumper and we're gonna mount this on the outside of the building. And then I'm gonna put two very bright lights in there. And then at nighttime, they'll come on with the photocell. So I've got to cut this, trim this back so it's at the right point where the bumper sticks out the right amount. And then we'll secure it to the wall so it can't be stolen. And it's already been, you know, someone's already scooped that. That's an automatic given. But I think I'm gonna run the electrical wires through that rusty hole right there. And then this one as well. If you look at this bucket, look at that's the paint code for the whole vehicle. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So I'm gonna mount this on here and see if we can figure anything out with the glass and the top part of it. But yeah, you can notice this bumper is already, you know, pretty rough. Like, man, it's taken a bit of abuse, but it's still pretty cool. It's still valuable to me. As painful as it is to actually cut the stock bumper, it needed to be done in order to do what I want to get done. So now I guess I gotta fabricate up some bracketry, some way to secure this to the wall so it won't get lifted. So yeah, and I've also got a little bit of body work to do on this thing. Now it is kind of hidden, but if I take a hard piece of metal and a hammer, I think I can straighten this out. And I'm just gonna leave that panel just the way it is over there. I like that rustic look to it. So I think that's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. It's coming right along. Chop saws, they draw a lot of power. Only blew the breaker once, but anyways, yeah, this is gonna be the mount. What I used is a crude thing here, and I did this like that, and then I actually put that square tubing there, and I got it so I just got a wedge in here, so this was the correct, and then so I can weld here, and weld one half on there. And then, yeah, so anyways, it'll mount. Andrew, don't do that yet. Not yet. Because there's nothing on the other side. We have to mock it up as we go. So, yeah, anyways, I did this. which way did I go? is what way? Ah, this way. So I went like this. So this will mount to the wall here, and then this will go on top. Well, it's upside down right now, but we did some crude body work, just bending it out with the hammer, and it looks a lot better now. We're getting there. So we fabricated up some brackets there, and yeah, it's coming right along. I'm just shielding my eyes here. It's coming right along. Oh, you want the end the trigger? Yep. Yeah, so this coffee cup, this Tim Hortons coffee cup is working awesome. Got the bracketry just about ready to be set up there. And so yeah, we're just coming up with you know, the best placement so it looked the best. But yeah, this is looking pretty cool. So I think floodlights or something like that might work, or dang welder. Should have never bought a Fisher Price welder. So, thinking about it, just got thinking about it. I think it'll be too much of a pain in the butt to do the to put the split window on the glass and everything for that. So I think what would be easiest to do is just keep it the way it is, but put like blue light bulbs or something like that. I thought that'd be really cool, or red, or blue or red, or something that stands out, because you know, everything, you know, lit up at night. If it was blue, that's kind of like my favorite you know, LED color, but I don't know if I can find like maybe a heat bulb or something like that, a red heat bulb or something. But I don't know, we'll figure something out, but it's coming right along. I'm pretty impressed with the guys. We're all working together on, we're having fun working on this project.